Hey all, welcome to my channel Destination Next with Nandagopal. So basically it's a travel related channel, but also I have a lot of information around drones here because I use drones for aerial photography. So I have included this channel video as well in this particular channel. So this course is what I did recently, and this is a 5-day course, a DGCA certified drone pilot training. And I am sure there are a lot many people out there who are also looking out for this kind of information. I also want to know in terms of how this course is taught and so on and so forth. So I put up a small video which I'm sure it will be useful for you all. If you find it useful, please give a like in the channel, share with your families and friends, and more importantly, subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed till now, so that you show me support, as well as you can expect more such videos in future. With that, let's get into the structure. So this is the overall structure or topics covered in this particular course, and this, since it's a DGCA certified, most of the institutes follow the same topics. So introduction drone systems, safety regulation, drone operating procedure, drone maintenance and troubleshooting, simulator training, very important, because it's important to get hands-on in the virtual environment actually before you go and fly the real drone in the field, okay? And then the documentation pre-flight and post-flight, which is not just flying, you need to also do a lot of checks and pre-documentation before flight takeoff, and after flying you have to do again some more documentation in terms of logging your hours and so on and so forth. So that is taught here. And then you have a written exam as well, where you need to score around 70-75% is the minimum pass mark. And then of course certification is you get at the end of the course of completion. And then along with this, you also apply for your license in the Digital Sky platform, where after a few days you get your license, which is valid for 10 years, and you're certified to fly a drone which is of small category, which means up to 25 kilos category drones you can fly. And most of the applications what we normally require, like, you know, agriculture or for, let's say, for surveying, or for that matter aerial photography, wedding photography and so on and so forth, everything comes under this category. So that license really is useful for you to go ahead and then use it for commercial purpose, right? Drone for your commercial purpose. So that's your certificate, valid for 10 years. And which are the institutes which are trained in Bangalore? In Bangalore we have multiple training institutes. I did it from Neo Sky. Similarly there are other institutions as well, and again now all over India we have institutes which offer this training. So it's best for you to go and check out which one is closest to your place, and then, you know, do this course in the DGCA certified training institute, okay? So that's the institute part of it. This is me getting my certificate at the end of the completion of the course. And as I said, I put a small video so that it is useful for you to see how what are things which are taught and how it is taught, etc., etc. I hope this particular video will be useful for you. And if it is, please give a like in the channel, share with your families and friends, and most importantly, please hit the subscribe button in case if you haven't subscribed till now, so that you show me the support, as well as you know, you can expect more such videos in future. With that, let's get into the video as such. Thank you.
Here today and tomorrow, so 2 days.
In Digital Sky, It has to be get a UIN number, and the UIN number has to be engraved in the drone in a metal plate. And this metal plate should be high temperature resistant.
Right.
Okay. Why?
in case of crash,
crash burns. Happens to the aircraft, and there's most of the things and electronic parts, and the battery is also there. So there is a fair chance of getting it fire. So this should be high temperature resistant, so that you will get the, you can retrieve the data.
Okay.
And the range of this drone is 4 kilometers.
So
whatever details I'm giving you is from the manufacturer's
manual. Manufacturer, okay.
So the maximum distance is 4 kilometers.
Mm-hmm.
Ceiling limit is 30,000 feet MSL.
Okay.
And like wind resistance is 10 meters per second.
Mm.
Gust resistance is 15 meters per second. The payload will come
underneath. Okay.
So, okay. So you will attach a fixed payload here.
Okay.
It won't have a gimbal.
Okay.
The payload will be fixed.
Okay.
And the mainly used payload is Sony Alpha 6100 RGB camera. They use.
Mm-hmm.
So there is a slight difference in this drone.
Mm-hmm.
This drone use lithium ion battery.
Ion battery, okay. Okay.
Mm-hmm. So this has a power of 4200 mAh. So here you can see a like lever.
Yeah.
You just pull it.
Yeah.
This battery bay will open.
Okay.
Here you can see like three wires are there.
Mm-hmm.
This RC will give you 4 kilometers as it.
Right.
Okay, and there is one more thing which you have to see. Since this is a type certified drone, everything has a number.
Mm-hmm.
So here you can see a specific number is given.
Right.
The same number is given in this drone.
Okay, correct.
This will also be correct.
This is called anemometer.
Yeah, this is anemometer.
Anemometer, okay. Right. So it showed how much? What is the reading? Right now it's 0.
No,
0.8 to 1.0.
Like 1.0 to 1.0.
And you...
The color is the airframe. So airframe you have to check thoroughly. Like, okay. Second, you will check the propeller.
Okay.
Propeller also you will check any crack or any bend is there.
Yeah.
You should wear this.
Uh-huh.
Because the other people should know who is flying.
Okay.
If some emergency is there, where they will go and find the pilot? How will they know that who is the pilot?
Right, exactly.
So for that purpose, you have to like wear this. This is like mandatory. We will come to the battery. Okay, so this is the battery.
Mm.
Here you can see two wires.
Yeah.
Okay, this is charging
and
this is balancing port.
Okay.
So you can see a silver wire here. You can see this lipo checker. So this will go like. Okay.
Ah, I see. Okay.
Uh-huh. What the value?
24.
80%. Now here you can see all are full.
Yeah, full.
So it means it's 100.
Complete. Yeah.
This laptop is also full because I charged it yesterday, so this full.
Okay.
Okay. Now this also more than like 50. So that's also good. Now here we use this CD Fly. This is the application which you use for this drone. Now here you can see this is the interface. Okay, most of the drones or drone application you will have similar kind of interface. Okay, yeah, so this arm here you can see some like parameters. Okay, this is altitude, distance to home, satellite count, HDOP, voltage, video,
to loiter,
stabilization,
returning to home,
RTM. Okay,
mode change to loiter.
So when you're taking off, you should take off in loiter. Okay, now go up to 10 feet, hold it there. Fine. So this you have to do.
Yes.
It's mandatory.
Yeah.
Like, even if after takeoff, anytime you land the drone, if you take taking it off, do the control check. Okay, now who is flying first? I'll give the control to you, I'll tell the control to you. Okay, so now control to you, do the control check.
I think you're not okay.
So now, gimbal one also is going a little bit over.
Okay.
So in loiter mode, there are two modes. One is position hold, and is loiter.
Okay.
In position hold, just after you leave it will hover there.
Okay.
In loiter mode, it will go a little bit forward. So what you have to do, control to me. I'm pitching forward. If I want to stop, I will stop and give a little pitch back. If it's right also, like I am rolling right.
Yeah,
I want to stop, I stopped it, give a little.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Opposite.
Okay.
Only for pitch and roll. Okay, you're just, you don't give your like this.
Okay.
Just hold the joystick, hold it. Where you want to stop, you just leave it. Control to you. No. Pitch forward. Then sit.
Post-flight check.
Yeah. So, okay. You have to check all the pre-flight check in reverse.
Okay.
So, why I told to remove the battery first?
So that by mistake somebody so switches on the...
RC is already connected with the drone.
Drone, yeah.
So, you are doing the pre-flight check. You will be checking the propeller. You will be checking the motor. Some guy will come and like... See that okay, two
yeah,
lights.
Yeah,
so
two lights.
Like he is played.
Yeah.
It start like you right. know the RPM of right. Like it will come. It's carbon fiber.
Yes.
It has a good like you it see that it's lightweight, but it's like.
Well, it will not take off, but it will rotate. Yeah.
It will rotate yeah. and it will chip off your.
Chairs, like, yeah, exactly. Thing.
Let to cool down.
Okay. Okay.
This battery has to be charged.
Okay.
So you can see this is Skyhawk T200. Yeah. Last of the engine won't use this.
Okay.
For charge the battery.
Uh-huh.
Okay. So you can like. Charge with different
two batteries can be charged, is it?
Yeah. So you can charge any kind of battery in this.
I see.
Like you can go for lipo battery.
Lipo battery.
Lithium ferro, like lithium ion, like nickel cadmium, all the like different kind of battery.
Okay.
And maximum cell you can charge is 6 cell.
Okay. So this battery is not lipo polymer, right?
This is
lithium ion.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now one is charging port. So always you can see two channels here, channel A and channel B. So at a time one charger can charge two batteries. If you want to change the channel, you just hit the center button. Okay. Now first connect the charging port or like balancing port.
Okay.
So here you can see two grooves are there. So make sure that it goes inside.
Okay, that's a sequence.
Okay, now you connect the charging port.
So good morning everyone. So basically today is the final day, the 5 days training program of the new Sky PTO training. So today we finished our course successfully and then of course we got our certificates. So I thought I'll just have a few words from my the trainers. Two of them, very very good trainers here, yeah? Both Mr. Hari and Ms. Neha. So I'll just have a few words from them. So let's hear from them first of all. So Shami, thank you for the training. So hi sir.
Hi.
Hi. So, a quick word about your training in terms of what you teach in drone flying and such.
Yeah. So, basically this training is to get a pilot license in India. So, it's a small class pilot license. So, you can fly legally in India after getting this license. So, this consists of a 5-day course. It includes theory, simulator and flying.
Okay.
So, in theory you will get like basic knowledge of what is a drone, like what is then drone rules, etc. Then you have a simulator, so hands-on training in simulator first. So if you don't have experience also in flying drone, you will first be seated in simulator. You will get an idea of how the controls works. Then you will be taken to flying. So you have to
complete
certain hours of flying.
Okay.
Then you will have your flying test.
Okay.
So if you pass the flying test, you will be getting a RPC, remote pilot certificate, which is our license.
Perfect. Thank you so much. So now what we'll do is we'll also hear from Ms. Neha in terms of what are the opportunities which are available for a drone pilot and what are the avenues which are there, what different avenues. Okay. So here we go. So Ms. Neha, thank you for the training. So just want to know in terms of what are the different avenues available for drone pilot in India and abroad.
Yeah, so there are different applications where this DGCA course tells you only about the basic skills and how you can fly.
Okay.
Right. Apart from that, there are so many applications of
okay.
So in NeoSky, not only the DGCA course, but we also help our students
okay.
in excelling other skills as well, like where you can use this drone flight stuff in actual industrial-based applications.
Okay.
So that is a quality outcome of this training, which I would say students as well to just not focus only on flying, but as well as on some mapping perspective or photographic perspective, which will help them to improve their skills.
So it's not technical, it can be a hobby, it can be creative.
Yes, it can be a creative hobby, you can make a career out of it, right? You can start your own business and a lot of things. So
students.
Yeah,
or is there a minimum criteria, I think 18
plus? So for DGCA course, the minimum criteria is 18 plus, but 10th
somebody can initiate us, but at least we get the interest.
Yes.
So you do teaching for Soar?
Yeah, we do teaching for students as well, like building drones or raising drones and then mapping and all that stuff.
Great, thank you so much.